Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048. That's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Hi, I'm Robert from Richmond Hill, here to talk to you about Midway Family Dental. I went to see Dr. Jackson because his prices on dentures were the best I could find in the area. Their on-site lab made my dentures fit perfect. With their low prices, I could also afford to get the implants on my lower dentures, which they attached the same day. I feel like I have my natural teeth back and I can eat anything. And I do mean anything. Dr. Jackson and his team at Midway Family Dental are the best. Call them today and you won't be disappointed.
I ain't no Robert Ripley. I'm just plain old Woody Folsom, but you can believe this or don't. Thank you, friends and neighbors, for giving Woody Folsom Automotive a near-record month last month. I ain't never seen nothing like it, but I sure would like to. Y'all come see us. Call us or click us at woodyfolsom.com, home of the free lifetime powertrain warranty. Save $9,000 off MSRP on heavy-duty 2500s and 3500s. A real good feel-good deal.
Better get to Baxley for some 0% for 72-month financing. 0% on Silverado, Sierra, Tahoe, Yukon, Equinox, Acadia, Terrain, at all new Buicks. Find new roads and do some dealing. We're also loaded with certified GM pre-owned vehicles that have undergone 128-point rigorous inspections. They're Chevy clean. Woo! Hey, over 1,000 pre-owned in stock. All makes. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. We'll give you a deal.
A real good feel-good deal. Talk to me.
The helpful folks at Harris Ace Hardware say thank you for choosing Harris Ace as your favorite place to buy hardware and building supplies. Stop by Harris Ace Hardware and check out their weekly deals. Sign up for Ace Rewards and start earning points toward coupons and rewards. You'll even receive a $5 coupon just for signing up. Harris Ace Hardware in Jessup, Hinesville, Ulonia, and now in Brunswick. They are ready to serve your everyday building and hardware needs. Harris Ace Hardware.
In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic, it is important not to put your health care on hold. Preventative testing, lab work, elective diagnostic, and surgical procedures are available at Wayne Memorial Hospital and are vital to ensure your continued good health. At Wayne Memorial, we prioritize your health and safety. You can be confident that all appropriate safety measures remain in place to protect our patients. At Wayne Memorial, you will find clean, open areas in which social distancing is enforced. Surfaces are regularly sanitized by our skilled environmental services staff, and HEPA-certified air filters are located throughout the hospital, ensuring the cleanest air possible. Our staff has ample supply of protective personal equipment, and face masks and hand sanitizers are readily available to our patients. We look forward to the day when we are able to lift our no-visitors policy. Regardless of the COVID-19 virus, our friends, family, and neighbors are still suffering from heart disease, cancer, neurological problems, and much more. Please don't delay your important health care needs any longer. Schedule your services at Wayne Memorial Hospital today, where your health means everything to us.
Our customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested and may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee, number 5656.
Hi, this is your Sheriff John Carter. In the coming weeks, you'll be asked to decide on a number of issues and candidates that will affect the future of Wayne County. Early voting will begin July 20th, and the primary runoff is August 11th. I truly appreciate the support I've received during my 36 years at the Sheriff's Office. I look forward to the challenge of serving you for another 4 years. I humbly ask for your vote and continued support. I encourage you to go to the polls and let your voice be heard. Remember, experience counts. This is your Sheriff, John Carter, proudly serving our community. Paid for by the committee to re-elect John Carter.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for a little latest in local news. In the news, General Assembly ended its session this past Friday, and they passed the budget, which goes into effect July 1st. On Friday, Governor Brian Kemp signed into law a Georgia hate crimes bill that strengthens the penalties for those that are convicted of crimes committed against people based on characteristics such as race, sexual orientation, or gender identity. Kemp thanked lawmakers who worked on a bipartisan basis to get the bill passed. Kemp said in signing the legislation, quote, "Today we stand together as Republicans and Democrats, black and white, urban and suburban communities, to affirm a simple but powerful model that claims Georgia's state too great to hate." Kemp says that it's a sign of progress and it's a milestone worth applauding. Budget did get passed, a $26 billion spending plan that begins next week, begins this week. The budget, which starts Wednesday, includes spending cuts in everything from K-12 schools and universities to health care programs and law enforcement. But the good news, no furloughs for state employees. It also calls for the state to borrow $1.1 billion for construction, maintenance, and improvement projects from roads and bridges to schools and campus facilities. Overall, the spending, which was first projected to be around 14%, ended at 10%. Kent was also pleased with the overall budget, telling lawmakers, if you pass a conservative budget that reflects our values, prioritizes education, health care, and public safety. The coronavirus pandemic has brought record unemployment, and thousands of businesses either closed or still struggle to remain open. Again, the difference between the 14% cut originally and the proposed 10% in this year's budget is about $1 billion. Cigarette tax increase bill stalled in both chambers, as House Speaker David Rosa made it clear his chamber would not consider it, saying doing so would be a job killer. Under the budget, General Assembly members will see their $17,000 salaries cut 10%, while Lieutenant Governor Jeff Duncan agreed to take a 14% cut in his salary. We'll be back with more news after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
We're doing it up big at Neesmith Chevy Buick GMC in Jessup. We're talking big savings, big rebates, and one of the biggest truck inventories in the South. Save up to $13,000 on new Chevy and GMC trucks. We're even offering 0% financing for up to 84 months. That's how you do it big. See us today at Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC, Highway 341 in Jessup, or head to neesmithjessup.net, where you can shop, click, and drive from the comfort of your own home, and we'll schedule your delivery. Chevy, find new roads.
When further treatment is no longer an option, hospice can provide services to manage symptoms and difficulties caused by illness, emotional, psychosocial, and spiritual care, as well as support to the families and caregivers are all part of hospice care. Hospice of South Georgia has been a part of the health community in Wayne and surrounding counties since 1998. The professional yet compassionate attention provided by our staff is unsurpassed. Widely supported by donations from the local population, Hospice of South Georgia is the local nonprofit hospice in Wayne County. Our administrative office is located at 1625 Sunset Boulevard, and Hospice of South Georgia accepts anyone who meets hospice criteria, regardless of their ability to pay. Please call 912-588-0080 to speak with someone about hospice care. That was 912-588-0080. We are your hometown hospice, and we are here to serve you. Hospice of South Georgia, working to add life to your days.
When you have an accident, you, not the insurance company, chooses the body shop, and you only need one estimate. All you have to do is call Jerome Riles at B&C Collision Center in downtown Scriven to deal with the adjusters and insurance company. Whether it's a little ding or a major crash, that B&C Collision Center across from Wasden Cabinet Shop in Scriven, deal with the insurance company so you don't have to. Call them at 579-2274. That's 579-2274.
In other news, this past Friday, Baxley pharmacist Ray Dixon, age 42, was sentenced to 4 years in federal prison after pleading guilty to a conspiracy that involved health care fraud and illegal distribution of opioids. In addition, Dixon will be on supervised release for 3 years following completion of his prison term. According to court documents and information presented during the sentencing hearing, Dixon distributed both Oxycontin and hydrocodone to several individuals without a legitimate prescription issued by a doctor. Upon inspection by agents from the Drug Enforcement Administration, Fulgham Pharmacy could not account for more than 10,000 units of controlled substances. Dixon, through his pharmacy, was also a major source of opioids for patients of notorious convicted pill mill operator Dr. Frank Bynes, Jr., distributing in excess of 110,000 units of opioids and other controlled substances over a 15-month period. In addition to the distribution, Dixon created fake prescriptions for expensive medications and then billed insurance programs, including Medicare and Medicaid, despite the fact that the medications were neither prescribed or dispensed. According to information presented during the sentencing hearing, Dixon's fraud amounted to more than $1.8 million, which he will be required to pay back as restitution.
He also agreed to forfeit cash, vehicles, and investment accounts as part of his agreement with the government. Once again, pharmacist Ray Dixon from Baxley, Georgia, sentenced to serve 4 years in federal prison this past Friday. We're now just weeks away from early voting in the Democratic and Republican runoffs, with the election date August the 11th. Here in Wayne County, the key runoff is for the Republican nomination for sheriff, as the incumbent John Carter and challenger Chuck Mosley advanced from a field of four candidates this past Thursday at the Wayne County Farmers Market. Candidate Chuck Mosley held a meet and greet with prospective voters, and we had a chance to talk to him about the event and the fact that he's announced if elected, he'll select Mike Hargrove as his chief deputy.
Candidate Chuck Mosley, the runoff is August 11th. The campaign early vote starts on the 20th of July. A good crowd here for you. Turn out, tell us about this event here tonight.
Well, this is just a meet and greet. I hadn't had anything during the whole campaign, and just wanted to get out and for folks to come out and see me and talk to me. Got a pretty good crowd. A bunch of Mosleys. You got to have a gun or a knife to beat him.
A lot of hot dogs being served,
yeah,
for sure.
Yes.
But, you know, the campaign, a lot's been made. You've announced who your chief deputy would be if you become elected, Mike Hargrove. A lot's been said about that. Just your thoughts on that, why you would announce it early, and what's your action to the reaction?
It was a mistake. I'd have been better to just kept my mouth shut, because I believe if I'd have elected Jesus Christ to be my chief deputy, somebody would find a problem with it. But the truth is, I look back with the past two chief deputies that's been appointed at the sheriff's office. They were kind of done without advertising and all that, but regardless, I won't do anything to cost the county money. I'll research it before a move's made. I was asked a question, and in honesty, I'd talked to that man about it, and I told his name. And he had actually said that he would be in agreement with that, and I did. But I probably shouldn't. I'd have been better off. It would have been a smart thing not to say anything.
Well, it's clear you can't fire anybody, but
that's
does
right.
The sheriff have a right to reassign people
yes.
The department?
I believe the policy allows for that. I believe the Wayne County policy, and that's what that it would be under. There's other merit systems around Wayne County. Brantley County is a prime example. Actually, in Brantley County, the sheriff that's there now, whenever he was elected, he moved the chief deputy. Didn't affect his money. He just moved him from the position and appointed his own chief deputy. And I think that's something that could be done, but I'll make sure of that before anything's
done. Everybody knows Mike Hargrove's right now the city police chief of Scriven. Why Mike Hargrove? You and him good friends, or you just have a lot of visibility?
We've been acquaintances for years, but I know his experience. He's been in law enforcement just about as long as I can remember, and he's got administrative experience. But the big thing is like I've told you before, is he's the kind of fellow to look me in the eye and tell me if I made a mistake or if he thinks I'm doing wrong. And I'm the kind of fellow that I like somebody that won't lead me astray. I don't want him to pat me on the fanny and let me walk in the ditch that's over my head.
What's your message going to be to the people tonight? Are you going to speak to the people tonight, or just meet and greet?
It's a meet and greet, and I may speak to them here in a few minutes. But the big thing that I'm hearing in the county, and everybody is the drug enforcement and the city and county working together. And, of course, be a little bit tighter on the overtime budget. But I don't know whether the opportunity arrives. People's eating and leaving, and I may speak to them in a minute.
Okay, Chuck, well, always good to see you. And like I said, we'll follow the campaign all the way up through August 11th. But July 20th is going to be here before you know it. Early voting will begin, and we'll see how it plays out. Hopefully, a good turnout. Should be a bigger turnout this time around with the presidential race in November. So that should draw a lot of people to the polls.
Yes, sir. Maybe so.
I wish you best of luck.
God bless you.
And once again, those comments are Chuck Mosley. Again, the runoff date is August the 11th, but the 3 weeks of early voting begins Monday, July 20th. The only runoff in the Democratic side is a race for First District Congress, with the winner of the August 11th runoff squaring off against incumbent Buddy Carter, who's the Republican candidate in November. The runoff on the Democratic ticket for the first congressional seat is between Lisa Ring and Joyce Griggs. If you did not vote in the primary, you are eligible to vote in the runoff. If you voted in the primary, you must vote the same party you did in the primary. If you vote a Republican, you must vote Republican in this race. And if you voted Democratic, you must vote Democratic in this race. Again, the runoff is set for August 11th, with early voting beginning July 20th. If you need any information about voting, call the registrar's office at 427-5950. We'll be back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
We're doing it up big at Neesmith Chevy Buick GMC in Jessup. We're talking big savings, big rebates, and one of the biggest truck inventories in the South. Save up to $13,000 on new Chevy and GMC trucks. We're even offering 0% financing for up to 84 months. That's how you do it big. See us today at Neesmith Chevrolet Buick GMC, Highway 341 in Jessup, or head to neesmithjessup.net, where you can shop, click, and drive from the comfort of your own home, and we'll schedule your delivery. Chevy, find new roads.
Western Sizzlin' is open 7 days a week at regular hours. Their popular seafood buffet Friday night from 4 until 8. Breakfast back on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday mornings from 7 until 11. Stop by today and enjoy all your favorites from Western Sizzlin's menu or enjoy their amazing buffet 7 days a week. Don't forget the to-go window Monday through Saturday, 11 until 7. Western Sizzlin' on South 1st Street in Jessup. Now back to normal hours and menu 7 days a week.
This is Charles Huffman at Jessup Housing Outlet. If you haven't been to Jessup Housing Outlet lately, you're missing out on a large selection of new and exciting floor plans from the nation's top manufacturers like Clayton, Fleetwood, Scottbilt, and Homes of Merit. All of our homes feature modern kitchens and appliances, R60 and higher insulation values, thermopane windows, and energy-efficient heat pumps. We have two locations to serve you, 2452 Savannah Highway in Jessup and Highway 301 South between I-16 and the bypass in Statesboro. Come see Charles, Fay, or Sherida today.
Simply the best. Those words describe Skag Commercial Mowers. Skag Commercial Mowers are sold at Knight Saw Company in Baxley. Skag Mowers have been voted number one in outdoor power equipment, including overall satisfaction and product quality. They are made in America. 0% financing is available. Skag Commercial Mowers, simply the best. Check out the full line of Skag Mowers at Knight Saw Company on the Jessup side of Baxley on Highway 341, offering dependable products and service for over 50 years.
Final notes news, Jessup City Commissioners have a special call meeting set for tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. at the Cracker Williams Community Center. On the agenda under Old Business, second reading of the year 2020-2021 budget ordinance. Also under New Business, approval of a GFA loan, modification resolution, approval to amend treatment plant budget, and executive session for personnel. I just with the city manager, I just with the commissioners, I just with the mayor, that tomorrow night at 7 p.m. at the Cracker Williams Community Center. We head to the July 4th weekend. Steady Georgia reports more than 11,000 new cases of the coronavirus from June 21st to Saturday, a new one-week record for confirmed cases that shattered the state's previous high set the week before. The 11,178 new confirmed cases reported last week was up 60%, according to the Georgia Department of Public Health. Georgia set a new single-day record for coronavirus cases in each of the past 3 days and topped 2,000 in a day for the first time with Sunday's report of 2,225 confirmed cases. Georgia Department of Public Health says confirmed cases are generally a snapshot of the virus from perhaps 2 weeks ago because people often do not seek a test until they exhibit symptoms, and it often takes days before the results are known. Current hospitalizations for the disease have climbed and are at the highest point since early May. State figures show cases trending towards younger people and adults under the age of 30, though the disease tends to be milder for young adults than for the elderly. The disease is not without risk and has led to at least 14 deaths among people under the age of 30 in the state of Georgia. Here in Wayne County, as of 7 p.m. last night, Wayne County reporting 57 cases. That's compared to Appling County, which is reporting 254, Jeff Davis, 99, Liberty, 114, Long, 37, Pierce County, 161, Glenn County, 533, and Ware County, 395. Once again, the Georgia Department of Public Health continues to ask that everyone do their part to continue to social distance, wash your hands, and avoid large gatherings. Georgia Department of Public Health updates the figures 3 times a day on their website, the times 9 a.m., 12 noon, and 7 p.m. Finally, the news, in 2018, Wayne Memorial Hospital in Jessup generated $125 million in revenue for the local and state economy. That according to a recently released report by the Georgia Hospital Association, state's largest hospital trade association. Wayne Memorial had direct expenditures of more than $54 million in 2018. Total economic impact of those expenditures was $125 million when combined with an economic multiplier developed by the United States Department of Commerce's Bureau of Economic Analysis. CEO Joe Roddy says, while we remain laser-focused on COVID-19 and our service line to all patients, we want to share these numbers, as we always have, with the public. He says our mission is not only to provide quality health care, but also to serve as an economic catalyst for the area. We're proud to partner with Jessup and surrounding cities to offer quality health care services close to home. As a leading employer in the region, we're dedicated to improving lives. Hospital is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and is committed to ensuring our residents receive state-of-the-art health care services. That's going to do it for the latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan saying have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO.
Here's your wake-up call from Woody Folsom Ford Baxley. More than 40 2019 Ford F-150s in stock at 0% for 84 months. Time to take action. Get in here and pick the 19 F-150 you want. Or pick the hard-working Super Duty in F2, 3, 4, or 550. Gas or diesel, 2 or 4-wheel drive, cab and chassis, flatbed, service bodies. Super deals on Super Duty.
We are zeroed in on 0%. Even 2020 F-150, 0% for 72 months. Or Farm Bureau members save up to $42.50 off sticker. Instead, and that's before we talk, plus a free lifetime powertrain warranty on all new and most pre-owned.
Ain't nothing to it but to just go on and do it. So get in here. Let's do some business.
Over 40 expeditions on the ground and on sale at Woody Folsom Ford. Better get to Baxley and talk to us.
Summary fixes apply. See delivery details.
We make it easy.
Let's roll.
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
This is Richard Johnson from Wayne County Emergency Management. Please remember to keep Wayne safe by continuing to observe social distancing and other good health guidelines. Remain at least 6 feet apart at all times. Wash your hands frequently for at least 20 seconds, especially having come in contact with commonly touched surfaces such as doorknobs, light switches, telephones, sinks, faucets, and countertops. Please call for sneeze only into a tissue or elbow. This message is brought to you by Wayne County Commission, the Cities of Jessup, Odom, and Scriven, the Chamber of Commerce, IDA, Emergency Management, Board of Education, Wayne Memorial Hospital, and Rainier Advanced Materials.
South Georgia weather. Here's your WIFO forecast. Hi, good morning. Watch for some patchy fog and haze early, but will be mostly sunny today. 20% chance of locally heavy afternoon showers and thunderstorms, highs in the mid-90s, heat index up to 104. Partly cloudy, 30% chance of evening showers and thunderstorms, mid-70s for tonight. Tomorrow, slight chance of showers and thunderstorms early, then a 50% chance of afternoon showers and storms. Georgia meteorologist John Weatherby in the GNN Weather Center.
Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Hey y'all, this is Amanda Griffin, the new manager for the Wayne County Farmers Market. I would like to personally invite you to come out and see all of the exciting things we have going on this season. From local produce, baked goods, jams, jellies, decor, jewelry, and much more. Located at 533 North 1st Street here in Jessup, we are open every Friday and Saturday from 10 to 2. Social distancing practices are in place to keep you safe while enjoying your shopping experience. And for those who would prefer to enjoy the wares of the market without the hassle of shopping, we offer weekly produce bags, a week's worth of produce for one low price of $25, with the option of adding a Hog and Bones Boston Butt for an additional $25. For more information on the market or to place your weekly order, contact me at 912-221-1233, 912-221-1233, or email me at info@waynefarmersmarket.com, info@waynefarmersmarket.com, or check us out on Facebook at Wayne County Farmers Market. Thanks, I can't wait to see you there.
Tired of living in pain? If so, come to Smart Physical Therapy located across from Dr. Hendricks behind the hospital. At Smart, we take pride in providing our patients with the one-on-one care that they need and deserve using advanced manual therapy techniques such as dry needling and manipulative therapy. Our compassionate and knowledgeable team can help you achieve the most optimal outcome. We will now be offering a free informational session every Friday from 12 until 2 on expectations following surgery. We'll be there one-on-one to answer any questions you may have. If you're looking to have surgery, give us a call to set up a free pre-op appointment. Remember, it's your choice where to go for your physical therapy needs, so choose Smart Physical Therapy. Our number is 559-2071. 559-2071. Again, 559-2071. Ask for Garrett Pye, Clayton Connors, or Nick Child. Smart Physical Therapy.
Psalm 34:8. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in Him. Fear the Lord, for those who fear Him lack nothing. Brought to you by the Ona Baptist Church.
Since 1946, Murphy's Builder Supply has been serving the folks of Jessup, Wayne, and surrounding counties with quality products and knowledgeable service. Matter of fact, they feel they sell service first to make sure you get exactly what you need for your home improvement projects. And with each employee at Murphy's being there for 10 years or more, you know you're talking with someone with the experience to help you with building supplies, tools, paint, and all the things you need from a full-service hardware store. The best choice in home improvement is Murphy's Builder Supply, 156 Northeast Broad Street, Jessup.
WIFO-FM, Big Dog Country, 733 on this Monday morning. Birthdays and anniversaries brought to you by Bargen Power Sports. Birthday wishes this morning going out to Vicky Boyette. Happy birthday, Vicky Boyette. Vicky Boyette celebrating happy birthday from the Trapnels this morning. William Freeze celebrating this morning. William Freeze. Also Mary Harder. Mary Harder celebrating. Birthday wishes for John Haynes. John Haynes. Krista Hopkins. Birthday wishes Krista Hopkins. Happy birthday Emily Martin. Emily Martin. Also Linda Tyre. Linda Tyre. And Latifa Williams. Latifa Williams. Happy birthday from the Robin Eubank State Farm Gang this morning. All right, Long County calendar on the 29th day of June. Happy anniversary to Carrie and Billy Ann Wingate. Carrie and Billy Ann Wingate, happy anniversary. Carrie and Billy Ann Wingate, that's your Long County calendar. Via Textosos this morning at 912-427-3711. You got time to shoot one in right now. Let's see here. Happy birthday, Timmy Nordberg. Timmy Nordberg. From Sandy, Andy, Barbara, Mom, and Tyler, wishing Timmy Nordberg happy birthday, Timmy Nordberg, this morning. Happy birthday, R.L. Miller. R.L. Miller from his classmates, the 1973 graduating class of Wayne County High School for R.L. Miller. R.L. Miller from the 73 class of Wayne County High School. Happy fifth birthday today to Cade Scarborough. Cade Scarborough from Cooper and Grayson this morning for Cade Scarborough. Cade Scarborough is five. From Cooper and Grayson. You've got time right now via text 912-427-3711. Birthdays anniversaries brought to you by Bargen Power Sports.
Famous birthdays today. Actress Lindsay Lohan is 34.
Hi, my name is Lindsay, and I'm searching for love. I'm recently single, I think. I'm a bit of a night owl. I'm a workaholic, a shopaholic, and according to the state of California, an alcoholic.
Comedian Larry David is 73.
Because my sandwich is a great sandwich, but I'm not really a fish guy. Yeah. And it's kind of a, you gotta like fish, you know. Yeah. But you like fish, but anyway. So I was thinking maybe you wouldn't mind switching with me.
And Dan Rowan was born in 1922.
On laughing. He's considered the more serious of the two. Will you welcome, please, Dan Rowan? I wonder, you have people come in and they do it very fast right into the camera, and then you take it and put it together.
Well, no, I don't take it and put it together. We have some very able editors.
All right, back with your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Monday morning, and we'll do that right after this for Bargen Power Sports.
Bargen Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Bargen Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Bargen has the full line of Kymco scooters. Don't forget, Bargen Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Bargen Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup, and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Monday morning. Happy fifth birthday to Cade Scarborough. Cade Scarborough is your winner from the Jessup Alma Bakery and WIFO. That the certificate is here at the station. Then you'll come by and pick that up, head to Walmart and pick up your prize. Bardrum Power Sports, Brunswick, Jessup Online, BardrumPowerSports.com brings you birthdays and anniversaries. Wishing Cade Scarborough happy 5th birthday. Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Monday morning. Well, it's kind of hazy, hot, and humid out there. The AC just can't keep up when it's like 80 degrees overnight and then heat index of 1,000,006 out there during the day. John B. Weather will check your forecast and a whole lot more ahead of your way on a Monday morning here at the Big Dog WIFO.
Happy birthday.
Cade Scarborough was 5 years old, winner from the Jessup Walmart Bakery and WIFO-FM.
Hello, Wayne County. This is Chuck Mosley. I'm running for sheriff because of concerns for drug enforcement, budgetary constraints, oversight and supervision, school safety issues, and relationships with local agencies. I've been a supervisor of law enforcement officers since 1999 in both state and county government. Experience matters. For a new voice, a new vision, a new Wayne, please vote for and elect Robert E. Chuck Mosley. Go to Mosley for Sheriff 2020 for contact information. Thank you and God bless.
Paid for by Chuck Mosley.
Marshland Community Federal Credit Union is now offering CASASA checking accounts. It's easy to earn CASASA cashback rewards. You can earn up to $9 cashback per month and ATM fee refunds nationwide. To earn rewards, just keep doing what you're probably already doing, the banking basics, what we call qualifications. Simply have at least 12 debit card transactions per month. Sign up to receive e-statements and be enrolled and log into your online banking at least once a month. That's it. If you don't meet the qualifications 1 month, don't worry, your CASASA cashback account is still free. Plus, you can get right back to earning your rewards the very next month. Visit us at 333 West Plum Street in Jessup. Marshland Credit Union is federally insured by the NCUA and an equal housing lender.
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Stop creditor harassment today. Stop the worry of a pending repossession, garnishment, or foreclosure. Contact the Bankruptcy Group, Attorney R. Flake Cabinets, for an experienced assessment of your financial situation. They have locations in Brunswick, Hazelhurst, and now Jessup. They are a debt relief agency. They help people file for bankruptcy relief. Contact legal assistant Tanya Blanton at 912-375-5620. 375-5620 to set up your free consultation. Let the Bankruptcy Group do the worrying for you. Now serving Jessup.
7:40 here at the Big Dog WIFO, so I guess it was that African dust storm that we've seen the past week or so. Man, it just really made things just very difficult to see, the glare and the haze and the humidity and everything out there. I was thinking about the Mount St. Helens in 1979 and all that ash from the volcano. That was a really, really cool summer. I mean, temperature-wise, at night it would drop down in the 50s, and you'd be up around 80, but the humidity was low. And I just wonder why the sandstorm did the exact opposite. Who knows? I don't know. It's been, 41 years ago, and memories fade. All right, let's check in with state news. Check that your GNN Weather Center forecast on WIFO. Here's John Weatherby.
Hi, good morning. Watch for some patchy fog and haze early, but we'll be mostly sunny today. 20% chance of locally heavy afternoon showers.